Good morning and welcome to St. Augustine's Parish as we celebrate the 12th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is our pastor, Father McSweeney. He's accompanied by Deacon Joe Cervello. Today's Mass is being offered for all of our parishioners and benefactors and for Joseph P. Hollihan. Just one announcement, festival news. The $100 raffle tickets are available at the parish office Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. Someone will walk away with $10,000, $5,000, or four $1,000 prizes. Maybe it will be you, but only if you take a chance. Only 400 tickets will be sold at $100 each, so get together with family members or friends to share in the cost of the ticket. Please see today's bulletin regarding the need for blackjack dealers and what items are needed for our white elephant sale. Our processional hymn is "O Bless the Lord, My Soul," number 561.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, to prepare ourselves to worthily celebrate the sacred mysteries, we must first call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. May God bless you as you minister the body of Christ to our brothers and sisters who cannot be present here with us. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name. For you never deprive of your guidance those who set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands? When I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall you proud waves be stilled.'" The word of the Lord. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat just as he was, and other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even wind and sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever. Great Dutch artist Rembrandt van Rijn did a series of paintings, drawings, and etchings on sacred scripture, his religious works. Perhaps because his mother was Catholic, he had no problem putting the image of God on paper or with paint. And one of his great religious works was based on today's gospel, The Storm on the Sea of Galilee. It's a beautiful painting. It's a ship with a sail, the apostles panicking, Christ in the back of the boat, many of them gathered around him. Waves are coming over the side of the boat. And by itself, a beautiful piece of work. But if you study it, you eventually realize there's one too many people on the boat. It's supposed to be Jesus and the 12 apostles, but there are 14 characters there. And if you study it even more, you notice that the character in the center, who's looking at the viewer of the painting, holding his hat against the wind, is a self-portrait of Rembrandt himself. He placed himself in the story. Because that's what Christ really wants us to do with all of the stories of his life in this world. He wants us to place ourselves within them, because that's how we truly learn. Today's gospel reminds us that we must constantly be trusting in the Lord. For the first reading prepares us for that. The book of Job. The great English writer G.K. Chesterton said that the book of Job is a riddle, something that it's hard to understand, which is true. But today's gospel gives us, in the story of Job and all the questioning that has gone before it, the eternal God finally speaking to him. And instead of answering all his questions like a good rabbi, the master asks him a question. He tells him, "Well, who do you think made all of this stuff? Were you there when I created the seas? Were you there when I formed the earth?" Because we'll never truly get answers to our questions. That's not why Christ came here. He didn't come so that we would find answers. He came that we would find trust. And that's what these two readings teach us. If we listen to them, we will all have storms in our lives. We will sometimes feel like we are sinking in this world. All we have is the trust of our God to get us through those things, and that's what he promised us he would do. He would always be beside us through the storms. He will calm them occasionally, but they will always be present somewhere in this world, and we must always understand that. He does not come to give us the answers. He comes to teach us to trust him. And that's a great act of the will that we have to
remind ourselves of. This great month of June, the Catholic Church has always dedicated to the month of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, though others claim June is something else these days. June is the season of trust. Sacred Heart of Jesus, I trust in you. It's one of those things we have to keep reminding ourselves of and repeating, perhaps, so that we can get through the things that sometimes can overwhelm us, sometimes the things that can try to sink us. We simply have to say, Sacred Heart of Jesus, I trust in you. Sacred Heart of Jesus, I trust in you. Because that's the thing that gets us through the challenges of this world. He never promised to remove them. He promised us we would get to the other side. And that's the thing that frames our lives, that with Christ in the boat with us, and he promised to be with us always until the end of this world, with Christ there with us, we have nothing truly to fear. The only thing we fear is separation from him, and we're the only ones who can do that. Nothing in this world can separate us from the love of Christ, and that we have to always rely on that great trust to get us through, to know that this imperfect world will never be made perfect until the Son of Man comes and purifies it, and that at that purification he will separate the goats from the lambs, the wheat from the chaff, and we pray to Almighty God that we're on the right side of those equations, that we are the ones who have trusted in him and dealt with the challenges that were placed before us, never abandoning his love for us, never violating his teachings, because it is those things that will sustain us, those things that will give us the courage to persevere. And like Job in the first readings, those things that we may not fully understand, but if we trust in him, we will get through them and find that the end of our journey is our reward for doing so. Because no one in this world is guaranteed eternal life. It's only guaranteed to those who follow Christ in this world so that we can be happy with him in the next. And we cannot give in to the ways of this world or fall victim to the storms that are out there, the currents that run against the truth, the darkness that tries to overcome the light. We must always recognize our role in the history of salvation is to be those who follow and trust in the Lord always, and that we never waver from that resolution. We always understand each and every day of our lives that it is only with the help and mercy of Almighty God that we can get through the things that overwhelm many, and that especially in this month dedicated to the Sacred Heart of Jesus, we remind ourselves to constantly be calling on him, because without him we are lost, without him we will fall, but with the Sacred Heart of Jesus and our trust in him, we can deal with all the storms of this world.
Now let us stand and profess our faith together. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all
of the world to come. Amen.
Turning to our Father in heaven, we see. now offer him our prayers and petitions.
For Pope Francis and all bishops, that they may safeguard and teach the holy truths of our faith with conviction, we pray to the Lord. For all those suffering in mind, body, or spirit, that they may be consoled by the peace of Christ, we pray to the Lord. For our parish community, that we may continue to be generous with our time, talents, and resources for those in need, we pray to the Lord. For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, religious life, and diaconate, especially from our own parish, we pray to the Lord. For the sick of our parish, especially Dr. Ali Jafari, Jorge De Los Rios, John Cryan, Teresa Timmons, Christopher Santiago, J.R. Milano, Joseph Scott Parkus, Thomas Albanese, Donna Pellucci, Peace Aiden, Gertrude Pinckney, Barbara O'Donnell, Joe Rodriguez, Angela Separano, and Maria Reynolds, that they may receive God's comfort and healing, we pray to the Lord. For all who have died, for Edward Turnchalk, and especially for all our parishioners and benefactors, and Joseph P. Holohan, for whom this Holy Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. We pray for stronger marriages and families, for those in single life, for a greater respect for all human life, for all the intentions in our parish book of petitions, and for all the intentions which we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Most loving Father, we beg you to look with favor upon our prayers and to answer them according to your most holy will. For we ask these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is I Love the Lord, number 481.
I love the Lord.
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, this sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offerings of hearts pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer to you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
If Christ can be saved for the last time.
Communion hymn will be You Are Near, number 440.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
you. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. St. Michael,
the Archangel, defend us from God, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen. Our recessional hymn is O God Beyond All Praising, number 545.